Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da, habita fillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitabihi al-kareem, innal insana lafi khusr. Allah tabarakallahu ta'ala says, verily mankind is at a loss. Habita fillah, we need to give special attention to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala umuman, in general, and those verses khususan, specifically. And the reason being is because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that mankind is in a loss, we have to take heed. Limadha, we have to ask ourselves why. Why is mankind in a loss? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins the ayat wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr. He says, he swears by the time, verily mankind is in a loss. So Allah tabaraka ta'ala swears by the time, which shows us the significance of time. For Allah tabaraka ta'ala to make time worth swearing by, tabaraka ta'ala, and only he subhanahu wa ta'ala can swear by the time, it shows us the significance of time and using our time for khair, so that we are not of the khusran, of those people who are khusr, those people who have who are in a loss. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, innal insana lafi khusr, verily mankind is in a loss. Then he mentions those who are not in a loss. Tabarak wa ta'ala. Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala fi kitabil kareem, innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu. He says, verily, except those who have faith. Ahli iman. Ahla tawheed wa sunnah. Ahla tawheed wa sunnah. We can say that with surety, because tawheed wa sunnah is the only way a person's iman will be accepted. It is not sufficient to worship the graves. It's not sufficient to have these ta'weed and with deities mentioned on your ta'weed and supplications, bid'iyya wa kufriya, you know, shirk and bid'ah, khurafat, things that go against Islam in totality, that resemble Catholicism before they resemble Islam. That's not sufficient to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is not sufficient. That those things contradict tawheed. They contradict iman. They contradict those things which when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions ahli iman, illa alladhina amanu, those people who have faith, though, that contradicts faith. Because ahli iman wa tawheed, they believe in the arkan al-Islam. They believe in the arkan al-Iman. Haqqan. Meaning that they believe that all of their worship, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And they base their worship on the Quran and the Sunnah. That which is legislated by the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not the opinions of men. Not the opinions of so-called awliya. Not the opinions of others. But rather, they go back to the book and the sunnah, and they go back to tawheed khalis. Innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu, except those who believe. And that belief has to be based upon the Islamic creed. Innal ladina illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat. So the second sifa or characteristic that these people of Ahli Iman must possess, these people who are not in a loss, they believe and they do righteous deeds. So that means they believe and they practice. So, for example, they understand the pillars of Tawheed, or they understand the characteristics of Tawheed, or the criterion of Tawheed, or the Aqsam, or the divisions of Tawheed. Tawheed Ar-Rububiyyah, Tawheed Al-Uluhiyyah, Tawheed Al-Asma'i wa Sifat. And they practice. They practice. They practice when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa iqama salat, establish the prayer. Ahli iman wa tawheed, they establish the prayer. And they do it based on the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Tawheed wa sunnah. Illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati وَتَوَصُوا بِالْحَقِّ And they advise one another and call one another to the truth, to the haqq, to tawheed wa sunnah, not to bid'ah wa khurafat. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ And they're patient through that whole process, that whole, the patience with Iman. Iman requires patience. Why? Because most of the creation is on misguidance. Most of the creation is on kufr and disbelief. Most of the creation ostracizes Ahl Tawheed. Think about that. Most of the creation, in some form or another, not just that they contradict Ahl Tawheed, but they ridicule Ahl Tawheed. Think about Ahl Bid'ah wa Zandaka wa Ilhad. And these are people who consider themselves Muslims, but yet they curse the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. Or they say that their imams are infallible, that their imams have a position like the Prophet, or even greater. وَعِيَّذٍ بِاللَّهِ وَعِيَّاكُمْ مِنْ بِدْعَ وَكُفَرٍ So you see that these people consider themselves Muslim, and they go against the tenets of Islam. What about all the rest of the creation that doesn't even consider themselves Muslim and are not Muslim, ba'een on Islam, how they feel about Ahl Tawheed? They consider Ahl Tawheed extremists. Ahl Tawheed is out of the time. They're not modern. Ahl Tawheed is not scientific enough. Ahl Tawheed is restricted in the text and their understanding of the text. Ahl Tawheed is not, you know, as Dr. Qadi, you know, explains how they're going forward. But yet Ahl Tawheed is maybe going backwards. It's just not, it's not up to par with what Dr. Qadi, he's reached another level of scientific discovery and I guess Iman and understanding of the deen that the Salaf Saleh, Ridwanullahi alayhim, they didn't get that. So I don't know what Qadi's drinking. Maybe it's his Starbucks. Could be. I drink Starbucks, but I didn't get that understanding. So it shows us Ahl Tawheed wa Iman, they restrict themselves to the book and the sunnah and the interpretation of the Salaf Saleh. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us to be from Ahl Iman wa Tawheed wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.